this lecture we are going to do the second part of our proof, which shows us that given to us a push down automata, we can convert it into an equivalent context free grammar. So there is just one idea which is at the heart of this entire proof. If you understand that idea, then everything is simplified. So to do this, you should only realize one thing. Given to you a PDA, if this is the initial state of my PDA and this is the ending state of my PDA, when do you say that a string is accepted on this PDA? There were two rules for this. So we say that a string is accepted on this PDA if, so stack is always empty at the beginning, the stack is always empty at the end. So the first condition, we say that your input string is accepted if, first thing, at your QF, the final state, your stack is empty, and second case, you have reached the end of the input tape. By end of the input tape, I mean you have read your input completely. Input tape is an infinite tape. So I say that you have read the input completely. So for the acceptance, here your stack is empty, and at the end state also your stack should be empty. Now please note that there can be some state here in between. So if this is your Q start, if this is your Q final, so there can be some state in the middle where also your stack has gone empty, right? But your string is not yet accepted, because it might be the case that your input string is not completely read here. So you are still reading some alphabet, some part of the input is left, right? Even in that case, here although your stack is empty, your string won't be accepted. You still have to continue further and read this entire input over here. For doing this proof, we make an assumption, and the assumption is at any given step, at a time or at a step, we only do one of the two things. We either push a symbol on your stack, or we pop a symbol from the stack. We either push a symbol to the stack, or we pop a symbol from the stack. We do not do same things at once. You can actually see how you can do that. So this is again straightforward. So we used to do something like this. If I, let's say this is QI. If we have a A in the input tape and alpha in the stack, then we push a beta on the stack. So what this step was doing, it was doing both the things at the same time. It is popping your alpha from the stack and pushing your beta in the stack. We can replace this particular transition with two transitions. So first we can go to QK and then come to QJ, and at one time let's do only one thing. So what we do, so here we were doing pushing and popping both. We just only pop first. So if I see a alpha here, we just end up popping it, right? And here, without seeing anything, we just push a beta. So you can replace this single transition with these two transitions and achieve this objective. And the second assumption is there is only one accept state. So that we can always do. We have done it in our NFAs also. So how do we ensure that there is only one accept state? In case there are multiple accept states, you make them non-accept states, add one accepting state, and just add some null transitions here. So in this case, you can ensure that there is only one accept state in your PDA. So considering our PDA has both of these properties, we will proceed further. So we are only going to do one thing at a time, either push or pop, and also there is only one accept state. Okay. Now what we were working with, if this is our initial state, the stack is empty here. If this is the final state, the stack again goes empty here, right? And we had seen that there might be some cases in between. There can be some states which have an empty stack, right? But your input is not completely processed. first string won't be considered accepted in that case. Now, when do we say that we have reached the final state? What we are doing here is we start with an empty stack. Then you read some symbol from your input tape. Some symbol we read here. Based on what that symbol is, we either push or pop. So please see that since I am only at the initial state here, you cannot pop because your stack is empty. So your initial state is always going to start with a push. So you see some input on your input tape and based on that you push some symbol here. You push some symbol here. Now that symbol should be popped somewhere along the way, because when you reach the final state, your stack is again empty. Assume that the symbol you have pushed here was alpha. So along the way till the time you reach this final state, you should have popped this alpha somewhere. And after you pop this alpha and reach the final state, we say that the string has been accepted. So what all strings will be accepted by this machine? We say that any string which brings, so if it is your Q start here, this is your Q final here, which brings Q start to Q final while maintaining the stack in the same state. So what does the same state mean? The stack is empty in both these cases, right? So while maintaining the stack in same state, so all these strings will be accepted by the machine. Correspondingly, we will write the production rules. So, assuming that S is the start state, F is the final state. So, we will say we will have a production rule ASF gives, and what ASF should generate? ASF should generate all these strings which brings Q start to Q final while maintaining the stack in the same state. So here we are going to write some production rules, and this ASF here, it becomes the starting symbol of the grammar which we are going to write. Let's be clear about it. So ASF is going to be the starting symbol. We have to write the remaining set of productions here, what ASF is going to produce, but this is what ASF is going to produce, strings which brings Q start to Q final. Okay, let's see how do we come from Q start to Q final. This was Q start, empty stack, Q final, empty stack. Here some symbol was pushed to the stack. We have assumed that at any given time step in our entire process, either one symbol is pushed on the stack or one is popped. So here we have seen that based on what was being read in the input tape, a symbol was pushed here. Assume that that symbol was alpha and what we have read from the input tape was some terminal A. So on reading A, we have pushed an alpha here. So alpha was pushed here. Now over the period of time, what these remaining states here would have done, they might be doing some push here, they might be doing some pops, some push, some pops, right here on this track. So this track would be changing all along this way, and at the end it would again be empty. So there are two ways in which the stack can become empty here. So one way is the alpha which is pushed here, whatever the stack changes these intermediate states have done, assume that all those changes were above this alpha, none of the states touched alpha. So if they wrote something here, they popped something here, and here was a state, right? And what happened after this? This is the place where the alpha is popped. this is our first condition. If you look at your stack here, alpha was pushed, so the stack becomes alpha here. By the time you come from this state to the second last state here, still the same alpha was here. So I'm talking about the same alpha, not the symbol alpha. What we mean to say is whatever changes all these states are doing, they are happening above this alpha. Nothing is touching this alpha. And this is the place where your stack comes to this state, where again there is a alpha here and this alpha is being popped here. So this was my starting state and this was my final state. In that case, how can you write ASF? Can we say that ASF produces, so on reading an A, it pushed the alpha. So it read an A and it pushed the alpha. And assume that at this place when alpha was popped, the symbol read was B. So when this B was read, the alpha was popped, and this area here again is for the remaining states. So assume that this state is some P here and this state is Q here. So I replace it with APQ. Now what APQ means? APQ is going to generate all those strings which brings the machine from this state P to this Q while maintaining the stack in the same state. So what here we mean by maintaining the stack in the same state, this alpha remains as it is. So above this alpha, so you can consider it as above this alpha, there is nothing in the stack. If you look at P, if you look at Q again, above this alpha, there is nothing in the stack. We can write this as APQ. So assuming that, you can also look it like assuming that stack is empty at P and Q, the strings which bring your machine from state P to state Q. This is just the same way of writing what I was saying before. So you can actually assume that an alpha is not here, right? And the stack is empty at P, the stack is empty at Q. Then which all are the strings which bring your machine from state to from state P to state Q? Okay. So this was the, we will look at it again if it's not clear. Where we were saying this was the first way in which you can come from the starting state to the final state. So the alpha, this alpha was pushed here, this alpha was popped just before the last final state. However, it is not necessary. The second condition can be, you are again starting from S, this is the final state, some alpha is being pushed here, but this alpha was popped somewhere here. The alpha which was pushed here, that alpha got popped here, right? Here again some things happened and somehow the stack is again empty here. So you should notice in this case your stack will be empty here at S, the stack will be empty at R, and it will again be empty at F. So in that case, how can we write ASF? So since our stack got empty at R, so I can say it, all the strings which bring my stack from the state S to state R, which brings my machine from the state S to state R while maintaining the stack in the same state, concatenated with all those strings which get the machine from the state R to the state F, again while maintaining the stack in the same state. So we got two transitions. So we can write ASF as a p q b, right? And we can write asf as and you should note now that this is a recursive process. So let's talk about the first case. I'm just going into a bit of detail to make it more clear. We started from the starting state. We read an A on the input tape and we pushed alpha. This was my final state where we read an B, where we read a B and we popped alpha from the stack. So you read a A here and we read a B here. It was getting me to the state P, it was getting me to the state Q. So if this was the case, we have written ASF as A, APQ and then B. And then APQ was again looking at all the strings which bring state P to state Q while maintaining the stack in the same state. So this was the state of the stack, right? Now see, you can repeat the same process here. You want to come from P to Q while maintaining the stack in the same state alpha. That again, if you see, can be done in two ways. So one way is, again you should see that you cannot pop anything at P, right? Because it is given that, so at P you only have alpha in the stack which is getting popped at your state Q. So you cannot pop this alpha at your state P. So at state P you are only going to push some symbol. Let's say the symbol you are pushing is beta. So you are reading something called C here, right? And you are pushing this beta into the stack. And at Q again your stack is in the same state. So what should happen? By the time you come to Q, this particular beta should be popped. If you see it recursively, again beta can be popped in two ways. So one way is beta was just popped at the state which was here, just before Q beta was popped. So let's take two more states. Let's say L and M, right? Assume that beta was popped here. So you read a C here and the beta was pushed, and you read a D here and beta was popped. In that case, you can further write APQ as C, state which gets you from L to M followed by a D. So your ASF becomes this. So this is the first way. And the second way is, it might so happen that beta is not popped here. Beta is popped at some middle state, let's say N here. So in that case, you will replace APQ by something which gets you from P to N, and then something which gets strings which get you from N to Q, while maintaining your stack in the same way. If you understood this idea, the proof will be quite clear to you. If you understood how we wrote these two expressions, everything will be clear. You actually do it for every two states in the machine. So for every two states, while converting it to a grammar, what we do, we take for every two states in the machine, we do exactly the same thing. So we say that APQ gives A, AR is B, provided all those conditions are met here, or APQ can give you A, APL, and ALQ. We'll do it soon with the help of an example. How do we formally write it? If given to you a PDA, and let's say we have only one accept state. How we are going to generate the set of production rules of the grammar? क्यू नॉट इज द स्टार्ट स्टेट, राइट? सो वट विल बी आर स्टार्ट वेरिएबल गिवन द क्यू नॉट इज द स्टार्ट स्टेट एंड क्यू क्यू एक्सेप्ट इज द फाइनल स्टेट एज वी हैव डन हियर. सो दिस वॉज माई वेरिएबल. वी आर गोइंग टू मेक अ वेरिएबल हियर ए क्यू नॉट क्यू एक्सेप्ट. दिस इज द स्टार्टिंग वेरिएबल हियर एंड इट विल गो ऑन जनरेटिंग स्ट्रिंग्स इन द वे विच वी हैव सेड. वी आर गोइंग टू राइट अ प्रोडक्शन रूल फॉर ईच ऑफ दीज. सो लेट्स लुक फॉर दिस पर्टिक्युलर एग्जाम्पल हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू राइट इट. सो अज्यूम दैट फॉर एनी टू गिवन स्टेट्स पी एंड क्यू अ सिंबल विच वॉज पुश्ड एट पी. Assume that same symbol was popped here. So what do we do? For each possible pair PQRS which belongs to your states, assume that U is a stack symbol. So U is the symbol which is getting pushed here, which is getting popped here. And assuming that your input alphabets are A, B, you can have more, but I'm just picking two input alphabets just for using them as some sort of variable here. So in case we have, if RU belongs to delta PA epsilon, so what does that I mean here? If I am looking at the transition from P at your input alphabet A, right, and if it is pushing this U in your stack and going to the state R, so you should see that delta PA epsilon here is going to consist of a number of possible transitions. What I am saying is, if this is one of these transitions here, RU, that is on state P, I am pushing a U here and the input read here was A. If that is the case, and second case is Q epsilon belongs to delta of SBU. So, what does that mean? On S, when I am reading this input alphabet B, if I am popping this U here at S, what we are going to do? We are going to put a rule. APQ gives ARSB. As discussed earlier. So what this APQ means all those strings which are generated when your machine goes from the state P to Q while your stack remains in the same state. So we have seen how do we write it in this way. So this is the first one. Second one is for the case when your stack became empty somewhere on the midway. So what did we do there? Again, for each PQR belongs to Q, we can put the production APQ gives APR ARQ. Done. So, we need not see what is the input alphabet and what is being pushed and popped here. We can just write it in this way. And third, for each P belongs to Q, we can simply add EPP gives epsilon. So, what does this mean? If you are at a state in your PDA, you remain at the same state while reading nothing from the input tape, which is trivial. So, with the help of these three productions, you can generate the grammar corresponding to a PDA.